Alrighty, so you've probably seen that expanded text ads, or ETAs as they're commonly known, are about to be sunset on June 30th. So if you have any of those live, they will continue running, but you won't be able to make any new ones. So you need a new plan that doesn't rely on ETAs. Luckily, I've got you covered. And today I'm going to walk you through the best practices for creating RSAs, or responsive search ads, which are now the default in Google Ads. The first thing to note before we dig into best practices is that where RSAs are concerned, you need to be comfortable giving up some of your control to machine learning. I know. Machines aren't always the future, as Westworld aptly demonstrated for us. However, when it comes to Google Ads, Google has continuously proved that machine learning can be capable of producing stellar results, and at times, even outsmarting us. Just a note, don't worry too much about machine learning taking your job. As I've said multiple times, a marketer's role just shifts as AI and machine learning improves, meaning the name of the game is agility. So, get comfortable with giving up some control and allowing Google to do its best work. With that said, the method I'm going to show you strikes a balance between driving and letting the car drive itself. It's work smart, not just work hard. Just in case you haven't seen the structure of RSAs, they allow you to input 15 headlines and 4 descriptions. The algorithm will then mix and match those headlines and descriptions based on the user and all the other millions of data points it takes into account in order to try and show the optimal ad to the right person. Okay. We're at the point of the video where I go through the best practices. But stick around, because after that, I'll walk you through the template I've created for you to go nuts and create your own. Or it won't make you go nuts, but like, you know what I mean? Number one, don't do the bare minimum. Use at least 10 of the 15 headlines and at least 3 of the 4 descriptions. Number two, don't be repetitive in the headlines. Google won't show similar variations, so it's pointless to say the same things. Trust the machine. I really wanted to say trust the process then, but okay, trust the machine. Number three, don't put keywords in every headline. Share a feature or benefit or a CTA, but this should be obvious if you have your account structured. Number four, be smart when pinning. Pinning is one way you keep control, but remember, strike that balance, because if you give Google too many guardrails, it will drastically reduce the number of possible combinations, which potentially could impact performance. Number five, vary headline lengths. Google wants to show ads with multiple headlines, so it needs the flexibility to combine them. So don't make every headline 30 characters. Okay, so we've gone through best practices. Now let me show you how to use this G-sheet template I've created for you to use to structure your RSAs in the optimal way. I will say, we also realized when we were doing this internally for each of our ad groups that it served as a great way to audit your RSAs. So even if you already have them all set up for each ad group, try going through this process with a few of your ad groups, of course, considering, you know, the audience and their intent for those keywords within that ad group, et cetera, but optimize your existing RSAs for each ad group. As you can see, we have 6 categories. Keyword focus, containing headlines, containing keywords from that ad group. Features of funnel. User benefits of funnel. Brand messaging for consistency and feeling. Social proof and USPs. We put these together, but I've seen people keep these separate. And CTAs, because ultimately we want people to take action as a result of being served our ads. Under that, you can also see our descriptions. These do vary based on ad group, but we've also done a lot of testing to refine these so they stay pretty consistent. The next step is to utilize Google's pinning feature to do what I mentioned in the beginning and give the algorithm some light guidelines. And this is more about steering Google in the right direction based on your knowledge and insight from previous activity, and not to bend it to your will. To help with this step, we have a second tab in the template where you can create the ad structure. And we've actually found keyword focus ads have historically performed really well for us. So rather than give Google full control, we have featured keyword focus in each of our 3 structures. And in a true test and learn approach, make sure you try to test three different structure variations at a time. So once you've added all your new headlines to each RSA, you'll need to pin the categories of headlines based on the structure you're going with. So for structure one, pin all keyword focus headlines to position one, and all feature headlines to position two, and finally your CTAs to position three. Repeat the pinning with each of your three ads based on the structure you're going with, and just to note here that headline three isn't always guaranteed to show. Just to note, we use these buckets, but we're also a B2B SaaS company, and it might be slightly different if you're, say, an e-commerce or a fintech. So get started with these buckets in this template and then adapt them to suit you. Finally, I just wanted to touch on testing RSAs. I mentioned already that we've done a lot of testing with descriptions to get to this point. And the same goes for headlines too. So definitely don't stop testing when you shift to RSAs. To help with this, Google Ads has some good indicators when it starts optimizing and actually gives headlines a rating. When the algorithm decides something isn't performing well, it essentially stops optimizing for it and gives it very little impressions. So think about switching low performers out for other variants to try and improve the group. Another option for testing, depending on how much volume you have for each ad group, is creating multiple RSAs within each ad group and testing different variations or templates, as we've called them here. Don't be afraid to go heavy on the keyword group like we did. Or let's say your market's very price sensitive, then maybe you have a bucket for price and you go heavy on that and feature it in each structure. But always be testing. Right, that's it for RSAs. Now you can create new RSAs or do a little audit and improve your current RSAs. Thanks for watching.